Andrews McMeel Publishing presents Softening Time by Elena Brower. Performed by Elena Brower. Foreword. Softening Time is a powerful work of art that asks us to slow down, land, and open. It is a gift to read this collection during a season of transformation, to immerse myself in the nourishing power of these words. Elena Brower is a true artist who uses the depth of her spiritual practice to serve humanity. Her poetry is some of my personal favorite, not only because of its beauty and wisdom, but because when I read it, I can feel the power of her experience. Elena and I have been close friends since 2017. She was one of the earliest supporters of my writing, and I am grateful I had the courage to reach out to her. Our friendship blossomed over the years. When we both lived in New York City, we would connect every few months and go on long walks in Central Park. I remember how I felt on the beautiful fall day when she first shared some of her writing with me, and I'm so happy that even more people will get to benefit from her brilliance. She is someone I look up to. I take everything she says to me very seriously. Elena is truly one of a kind, an incredible beam of light. Softening Time is not only relatable, but it creates space for us to appreciate the small moments as well as the life-changing ones. I hope reading Elena's poetry serves you as well as it has served me. May these words help you move intentionally through the world. Young Pueblo. For James and Jonah, for the continuous softening. At every age since love was a possibility, there have been thoughts unspoken, mysteries revealed only in solitary silence, empty moments becoming holy within me. These are the times to practice softening. This book is a journey of forgetting and remembering that. Let Your Mind Sit. Roshi Joan Halifax. Introduction. Outside my bedroom window, watching the neighbors negotiate their relationships while listening to my parents clumsily manage theirs, poetry becomes my most magnificent healing secret. To express my emotional states through the written word is to dissect these states into digestible parts so I can guide myself through the misunderstandings of growing up. This is still happening. From the moment I learn to read, I devour everything I can: cereal boxes, books, poetry, magazines, novels. The written word provides me with ways to make sense of my experience, to let go of the unbearable pain that seems to linger in my limbs sometimes. Hours spent under my bed in the dark as a child, reading with my treasured flashlight, are a softening within myself. Reading and writing teach me how to steep myself in the colors of both grief and joy until I'm saturated. Our foundational challenge as humans in these times is to connect slowly, savor restful intervals, and find ways back to the words that give our daily activities deep meaning. What we need more than anything is profound attention to the instructive silences that dance between the words, to the glints of happiness that catch us off guard, to the depths of sadness that keep us connecting and listening. The ancient human wish to make sense of things and understand the supreme mysteries is alive here in these words, collected and edited from poems and prose written since I was 13 years old. You'll meet the influential forces in my life throughout these pages, from nature to my closest friends, from my teachers to my family. Each has played some role in shaping and creating this time of softening in which I find myself. May these pieces inspire your own softening time. Practice. Sun rising in my bones, calling me home. Quiet refuge, body of learning and listening, where unmitigated focus seduces, then silences me, evolving patterns quietly. I can see no other way. Recovery. Learning, landing. Heart grants boons older than words. Righteousness softens. Darkness to clear light again, hearing myself becoming my dearest friend. Grandmother's heart prioritizes stillness, patience. Simple medicine, evolving broken legacies. Grand entrance empathy. Morning. Punctuality means more to me as I get older, so I'm right on time. Setting down my things, listening to the remnants of last night's rain in the trees as the drops fall on the small stones beneath my feet, I tuck into an antique chair to wait. The peeling finishes on the benches and tables mark the onset of rainy season here. Everything's just slightly off kilter. This table is leaning a bit. That chair has an errant leg that needs to be nailed in. Something old within me finds this dilapidation charming. The surrounding trees are the ultimate counterpoint. Ringing the perimeter of this place, these lush green beings offer evidence of what thrives when human fabrications disappear. Heavy with dew, shimmering in their morning magnificence, these ancient plants in their very existence whisper to us about our own experience. We can sense this connection in some canyon of our cognitive comprehension. Regal, regardless of size, innately moved to rise and reach with life. They turn toward the sun in any given instance, producing copious energy with every breath, giving me ideas about my deepest self. Some words about believing in my own true nature arise and evaporate. For more flashes of understanding, I sit very still and keep waiting. Considerations. Silent, embodied words, the only reverence. Subterranean. Anguish pulses within my body, circumambulating myself, tending to the trees so I won't find myself in a heap of perpetual memories. No music, just cicadas, forbidding summer wind, a universe of signals pointing toward new topography. Kneeling down, surrendering, animating the mysterious ending of this barely discernible beginning. Time elapsing. Every year around this time, I think I hear the world collapsing. Evolution. First, I'm food and water. Stroller pusher, snack maker, book reader, sleep sender. Each day I peel back one layer of protection. Slowly I press you apart and away from me. I know it's time. I don't want to. I leave the province of usefulness, ensuring you touch into your capacities, sharing strength silently. Together we locate urgent compassion and ask more questions. What's true now? Have we grown up yet? Just ask the flowers. They're always teaching.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.